We're going to talk about setting up page breaks and margins in Excel. When you print a page or create a PDF, you end up with sometimes end up with a column on another page. We will discuss how to set up your page to have the page breaks and the margins the way you want them. Here we have a relatively large document. Now, in Excel, there is wonderful little buttons here that are quick to go back and forth. So right now you're on the normal view, which is this one. And then let's go to the page break view. And here your document is displayed for you. And the dotted line is where the page break is going to be. So basically you're going to have one page here and the second page with two columns. So what we can do is, because we have that, and then on the bottom we have the same thing, the page break is here, and you can bring it down to the end of your page. But so if we want to include these columns on our one sheet so it doesn't print on two different sheets, what we can do is click and drag the dotted line over to the edge to include both of the columns. And so now the entire document will print onto one page. Now be careful with this. Do not drag past maybe one or two columns. It reduces the size of the text when it accommodates your desires. And if you go much more than one or two columns, the text will be difficult to read. Now, the dotted line indicates the page break. The solid line indicates the actual end of the page. So if we go down to the bottom of the page here, you see that the end of the page has Dave on the first half of the end of this page and the first half of the next page. So I'd like to have all of Dave's sales on one page. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click and drag up to end this at Terry, and now your next page will start with Dave. So that is another great function, that you can have related information on one page by changing the page break preview. The next thing we're going to talk about is the page layout view. So let's click on the bottom button here, and we get the page layout view. And basically it shows you how your document is going to be printed. Now, to actually go to manipulate your page in the page layout view, you'll have to go to the page layout on your tabs at the top here. And there are many things that you can do with your page here. The first thing you can do is you can go to margins and drop down the list arrow below the margins icon, and then you can see that we're on normal right now, and you can switch to wide. And then you could switch to narrow. And the last thing we have on this list is we have custom. Now, I want my margin to be 0.4 on the sides. So right now it says 0.12, 0.25, so I'm going to go 0.4 and change them both to 0.4. The other thing that the custom has that's nice if you have a smaller document or doesn't fit up most to your page is you can click the box to center horizontally and center vertically. But I'm not going to select this option right now, and so I'm going to say OK. So the other things that you have in page layout is you have the orientation. So this is where you could change a portrait, which is in, to landscape, which would make it horizontal. And then going back to, and then you can select the size of page that you'd like. Would you like to print this on a legal page, on an executive page, and so on and so forth. So that is the pages. Now, to get back to your normal view, the quickest way to do it is go to your normal view button here on the bottom. And there you have your page set up for you. The dotted line now on your normal on the normal view indicates that this is where your page is going to end when you print it. So hopefully now you'll be able to create documents, either making a printed document or a PDF in the format that you'd like it. please subscribe.